Hey everyone, Robin here. We're back, and after exploring the great new enhanced light and color feature with its powerful new machine learning model, which you can check out in this playlist up here, we're diving into another machine learning enhanced feature. This time, it's the Smooth Slo-Mo algorithm, designed to make your retime clips look even more amazing. Let's take a look. So Apple gave Final Cut Pro's Retiming a huge update with version 10.8 when it comes to the quality of slow motion visuals in particular. While Final Cut has had the option to use an optical flow analysis for retiming clips since day one, Apple has now added an additional machine learning enhanced algorithm. For this, I'll just hit Command R to show the clip's retime editor, and if we look in the pop-up, you'll see that next to the previously available options, slow, fast, normal, and custom, we have a whole new smooth slow-mo submenu. Here, just as with the regular slow category, I can choose from three speed presets, 50, 25, and 10%. Mind you, this new method is only available on Apple Silicon, so M1, M2, etc. Max. So if you have an Intel Mac, you unfortunately won't be able to use this option. And even then, image sizes larger than 1920 by 1080 need to be analyzed and rendered to see the full quality in real time, which is what I always do anyway. Also, image sizes above 4K require a Mac with an M2 chip or newer, and the largest supported image size for analysis is 8K. For comparison purposes, let's start with the regular slow setting of 25%. Obviously, the more you slow down any clip, the more apparent any post-processing will become, no matter the methodology used. But that's actually what we're looking for at this point. The clip, played back without any type of quality selection, looks like this. Basically unusable. So why is that? Well, if we go into the menu for the retiming options under the viewer, for one thing, we can see that we now have the new Smooth Slo-Mo submenu here as well. Going further down in the menu to the video quality submenu, which is only available once a clip has been retimed, and looking in here, we can see that the quality levels have been slightly renamed fast to best with their previous names in parentheses. As we can see, by default, all the regular slow presets still default to the lowest setting floor. This basically does nothing but duplicate frames or round down to the nearest whole frame. Below that, we have the other three options as before, where optical flow would usually deliver the best results until now, especially when slowing to a very low percentage, and wasn't actually all that bad depending on the footage. Last in the list, we have the new best setting, which is also optical flow, but it has been enhanced by a new machine learning algorithm. In other words, when you use any of the regular slow presets, the default quality will be fast, and you can switch it to any one of the other now five quality settings. If you choose any of the new smooth slow-mo presets, the quality will by default always be set to best, the machine learning enhanced algorithm. Just to have a comparison to what we've had until now, let's select optical flow as the quality setting and wait for it to analyze and render, which I'll speed up here. And while it'll usually play back without rendering, you'll generally want to render to make sure you're seeing the final result. I picked this clip amongst others because it's a classic case where there is little contrast between the subjects and background, especially with the girl on the right, with her hair in particular. Generally, a recipe for an unsatisfying result with optical flow, since optical flow by itself just follows individual pixels, not actual objects, from frame to frame, basically following their flow across frames. But it'll struggle with bigger changes in brightness or color, so things such as flashing lights, fast camera movements, or object occlusions, which is when one object passes over another. I actually suspect it's only still an option for legacy reasons, meaning so as not to break older projects. After all the analyzing and rendering, if we play the clip back, we can see that the result isn't completely useless. But if we look more closely, then the typical problem areas become obvious. Again, if pixels aren't easily distinguishable as being the same across frames, then it loses track of them or mistakes neighboring pixels as ones from the previous frame and interpolates positions incorrectly, leading to errors in the flow estimates. The man's arm, for example, has heavy temporal artifacts at times because optical flow by itself relies on tracking pixel motion, and when one object occludes another, it has difficulty in accurately estimating the motion of both objects. Possibly because he's out of focus and therefore has poor contrast, which also shows up in areas like his nose. And as he passes behind her, both her hair and his contours are noticeably distorted and sort of meld together. Now to see how the new machine learning compares, I'll simply copy the clip by dragging it with the Option key, select the copy, and now set its quality to the new enhanced optical flow analysis powered by machine learning. So while this too is analyzed by the optical flow algorithm, simply put, the machine learning recognizes and tracks objects within the video. So in principle, the same thing you see with the scene removal mask for masking objects, only in this case for enabling object-specific speed adjustments. Therefore, as we'll see, it's much better at handling things such as the aforementioned issue with occlusions, for example. Once analyzed and rendered, if I play this back and we pay attention to the previous problem areas, we can see, while still not absolutely perfect, I think it's safe to say that the result is exponentially better overall. His arm and nose are fine throughout, and her hair is far less affected by him passing behind her. How much better this object and not purely pixel-oriented retiming is even far more obvious in the case of these two clips of some kids on their scooters and a much more extreme, usually way too extreme, speed reduction. In this case, I applied a speed ramp to both to accentuate the jumps and slowed them all the way down to 10%, something I would normally not even consider doing if not shot accordingly. Again, first without any quality changes, in other words, no intermediate frames. Clearly not something you'd use. In the case of the retime clip using only optical flow, I think one can see why a reduction to 10% would have been unthinkable. The temporal artifacts are massive. Both the foreground and background ramps are distorted over a large area, and the kid on the scooter in the background is the biggest distortion victim. And again, on the crossover between the two, during the occlusion, it's the worst. As I said, such a drastic reduction in speed is and was normally unthinkable. Until now? Well, let's see how the new machine learning retiming fares in comparison on this second clip that I've already analyzed and rendered. Once again, at this extreme speed reduction, not perfect or unnoticeable, but I think it's safe to say that the result is multitudes above that of optical flow by itself. There is very little distortion on the ramp, and the kid in the background is nearly perfect throughout the entire clip. Even as he passes behind the kid in the front, the artifacts are comparatively almost non-existent. So clearly the machine learning analysis ensures far better temporal consistency and generates intermediate frames that maintain the overall flow of motion far better than optical flow on its own. Of course, how good it will look depends on many factors such as content and, of course, level of speed reduction. Oh, and this can also be used when speeding clips up to improve the flow of motion in those cases too. Here are just a couple more tests that I feel really show the significant difference between the two methods. And while again, they're certainly not perfect, I find the results for the running dog, for example, particularly astounding. I'd say the only way to make this any better is to actually shoot at the needed frame rate. By the way, this is also available for another feature in Final Cut Pro that uses optical flow that I have a feeling only very few people even know about, the so-called Rate Conform. This is an option that becomes active if and when a clip's frame rate differs from the project's frame rate, especially when those frame rates are not even, so not divisible by two, such as a 30 frames per second clip in a 25 frames per second timeline, or the other way around. Most noticeable in fast linear movements, such as a quick camera pan. You'll often see a rhythmic stuttering, as by default, Final Cut Pro uses the floor quality here by default too, to match the clip's frame rate to the project's frame rate. And since the frame sampling methods have always been the same as for retiming clips, you've had optical flow as an option. And now have the new machine learning here too. As an example, I have this project set to 50 frames per second with a 25 frame per second clip in it. In other words, it only has half the frames per second than that of the project. Selecting it and looking at the bottom of the video inspector, we can see the rate conform setting is therefore active and set to the default, fast, or floor. If I step through the timeline frame by frame with the right arrow key, we see that Final Cut is simply showing each frame twice. Skipping the other options and setting it to optical flow. Stepping through the clip again, we'll see that now intermediate frames have been generated, just as we saw when retiming. And while it looks fine overall on playback, looking at the intermediate frames shows that this is a great example for something that optical flow by itself struggles with that I mentioned earlier, bigger changes in brightness across frames, in this case the blinking light. Watching the light on top of the car's roll bar as I step through the clip, it appears to be moving back and forth. The roll bar itself also gets quite distorted at times. I suspect it's because it's unable to differentiate it well enough from the trees in the background. Now if I switch the rate conform to best or machine learning and step through the clip as before, we'll see that since the car, roll bar, light and all is recognized and interpolated by the algorithm as a unit and not just pixels, the intermediate frames that have now been generated are much better and more consistent. The light doesn't move around anymore, and the roll bar is almost completely undistorted through the entire clip. Really nice. This becomes that much more apparent if I retime the clip. After switching it back to optical flow, I can use the retime editor to set it to 25%. Then create a hold frame at the point where the car is close to the camera with Shift H. Add a speed transition on each end of the hold frame and play it back. Again, the light and roll bar are heavily distorted leading up to and especially during the transition to and from the hold frame. Switching it over to machine learning and playing it again, we see how much more stable and consistent it is, resulting in a far better flow of motion. And maybe you noticed that I never even changed the clip's quality settings, as you would expect to have to. Well, that's because once either the retiming or the rate conform has been set to any frame sampling method, these settings go in unison with each other. So changing the rate conform back to normal, for example, also changes the video quality to normal, and the result is also accordingly. So, what do you think? Are you as impressed by the results as I am? Drop your thoughts and any questions in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, there's more where that came from. Subscribe for more Final Cut Pro tips and tricks, and hit that like button to let me know you want to see more. And if you're interested in diving deeper into Final Cut Pro's features and updates, check out the playlist or one of these related videos. Maybe you'll discover something else you didn't know. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Take care.